The work we're doing right now is really intended to help those with spinal cord injury really to regain movements. And the movements would be breathing, the movements would be arm movements, grasping, using their hands, or it might be walking, or even something like standing up. So we're trying to develop new therapeutic strategies that can help bring patients to a better outcome than they are with conventional therapies.
Therapeutic intermittent hypoxia, we believe it has a therapeutic or intervention effect.
So after years of work, we came to realize that repeated exposure to low oxygen, just slight decreases in oxygen, that increases the activity of a kind of neuron in your brain. It's a neuron that contains the neurochemical serotonin. And those broadcast all over the brain and spinal cord. And it triggers changes that we refer to as plasticity. The plasticity is in the motor nerve cells that innervate the muscle. And so what happens is that plasticity makes them work better. Even though it's below a spinal injury, even in one that couldn't really establish normal function. When we expose the subjects to the low oxygen, it's a level of oxygen that's about the same as if they had climbed Denali, which is the highest peak in North America. On the other hand, they never really get there. It's a journey that lasts 1 minute, and at the end of that minute, we return them to Gainesville.
Dr. Mitchell and I are co-PIs on a clinical trial award to study people with chronic spinal cord injury, and to really test, is therapeutic intermittent hypoxia effective for improving respiratory function? But also, could it be more effective if we combine the intermittent hypoxia with a conventional strategy such as respiratory strength training? It's part of our collaboration between University of Florida and Brooks Rehabilitation. So we're going to test that over 4 years in about 55 individuals with the chronic incomplete spinal cord injury. For people with spinal cord injury, respiratory illness and impaired breathing is a key cause of sickness, hospitalization, and death.
If this does work, it offers hope to individuals that have suffered so very long. They often suffered an injury when they were young, and they've been living with it for quite some time. And really after the first year after an injury, there really is little hope for further functional recovery. We hope to give that hope back.